Wow, this could be a strange one. I'm in Folkestone, it's evening, Saturday evening, and I was looking at some art, oil paintings in particular, and that's become the inspiration for today's video. Have you ever heard of Edward Hooper? He was an American artist and a realist artist known for his etchings, his watercolors, but mostly his oil paintings. Now, you might not know of his paintings, but you would know it if you saw it. There's the girl with the sewing machine. There's one called Gas. There's one called Automat. But probably his most famous painting is called Nighthawks. Now what he did, he created subdued drama out of commonplace subjects, layering a poetic meaning, and he invited the viewer to create their own narrative or interpretations of his work. So like in Nighthawks, you have this bar. Is it a bar? Is it a canteen? You've got three customers and you've got the guy serving. Now what he does in his realistic depictions of what's known as everyday urban scenes, he tried to shock the viewer into recognizing the strangeness of familiar surroundings. So my familiar surroundings are going to be down the street here at Rendezvous Street, because there's quite a few eateries and bistros. But what he tried to do was convey a sense of isolation or melancholy in his work that we could relate to or associate with just by viewing them, with kind of like, I could be there, or it means so much, or, you know, things like that. I'm going in and out of the light here. So what I'm going to try and do is, I've got the GoPro attached to the camera, and it's my intention that if I look at some of the restaurants or bars as I go down Rendezvous Street here, see if I can capture that essence of isolation and melancholy. I'm not sure I will, because people are out having a jolly, aren't they? They're having a good old time. But it's worth a shot, because we get the illumination of the restaurant or the bistro is all lit up while we're on these dark streets. So we get these nice orange illuminations. So we've got a bar on the right here called the Lucky Chip Dive Bar Restaurant Wine Shop, and that looks quite nice. We've got some people inside, and I don't know if I'll actually be able to capture. I should be able to get, probably not isolation and melancholy, because they're having a good time, but it's that whole essence. So I've got my scene. I'm using the GoPro now, so you can see the shot of the restaurant, people coming and going. It's kind of dark, so I've got the camera set on auto ISO. White balance is just auto. So now what we'll get is night revelers deciding that they want to be part of the picture. Can I capture an image of melancholy and or isolation? I don't think so. That was that shot I just took. So in the Nighthawks image, you've got the street, haven't you? And it wanders off. So I might be in the wrong angle here. I might have to just walk around, but rather nice. Let's take a few more. I'll do the gallery at the end. So here we're outside the Pullman. Might be able to get some kind of isolation thing going on here. Oh yeah, that looks nice. So we'll just make sure that guy's not in the shot in a second. He's going to disappear. Got some diners. I don't think it depicts isolation or melancholy, but it does depict activity at night, you know, the Folkestone Wine Company. So it's that whole kind of outside looking in, and you are invited to create your own interpretation of the scene. What is it that is going on? You know, is there happiness? Obviously there is there sadness? If I can try and capture a couple of people who are not engaged in conversation, it then allows you to draw your own conclusion as to what the conversation is going on about. I like the concept. I'll have to lock the focus in. Lock the focus in, because the camera's having problems locking in on things. I'm getting a bit jittery. There's people looking at me like, that guy's got a camera. We could take it off him. So if I go in here, it's a little more secluded. You're not seeing me, are you? Okay, so we got a little bistro across the road there. Some individuals. What would be interesting is to take the image and actually try and convert it with some filters on post-production and make it an oil painting. Make it a little bit more like an Edward Hopper thing. People walking by. I'm going to go zooming in on the lads outside. Pull it back so that we can get the shop front. I hear an American accent. No, he moved. That's good. Can you put your own interpretation on that? Certainly not melancholy. It's more joyous. Okay, maybe just a couple more then. Just for the exercise of this video. It was, you know, because I do landscapes and I do street photography, and I've not mastered portraiture yet. Oh, that's interesting. If you look through there, does that look interesting or what? See if I can get a shot inside. It's a shame about the scaffolding. I'm going to zoom right into the door. Snap, snap, snap. You know what it is? It's capturing real life, isn't it? It's a little like that's what street photography is. So I've got Lubin's pizza. And if I zoom right in, inside the window, so three shots. I want to try and get the whole scene of it. I'll get one straight on, but then what I'll do is try and get one as a side view. It's trying to capture that essence like the Nighthawks, where you're looking from the right hand side of the shop all the way around to the corner. We're having lots of fun with the lighting, because it's street lighting. I should really go into manual priority. I've just got it on shutter, forcing it at a 60th of a second. It's not in enough. And another thing, pre-planning. Pre-planning works a treat, doesn't it? Okay, I think that's it for this one. I just wanted to try and see if I could. I've been thinking about it all day long. Is it possible to recreate an Edward Hopper kind of vibe with photography, especially at night? And I think you can, actually. But it would probably mean doing it later at night when everybody's completely alone and or drunk. And then what do you get? You'll be either accosted. You can do it as a painting, can't you? Because it's from imagination. So I'm going to give you a little bit of a gallery now, shots that I took, and also maybe try and do a bit of hocus pocus on it so that we can get a representation of those images as an oil painting. I think there are some filters that I can use. Excuse me. So yeah, the lucky chip went up there and took a couple of shots, and all the way down there and took a couple of shots. So there you go. We like doing odd, don't we? Plus it's another video for the channel. So thanks for watching, bearing with. See you in another video. And here's the gallery. Bye for now. 100%.